We're asked to sketch the region enclosed by y equals 5x and y equals 7x squared, which I've already done here on the right, decide whether to integrate with respect to x or y, then find the area of the region. Recall when determining the area bounded by two functions with respect to x, the integrand function is f of x minus g of x, which is the top function minus the bottom function, and the limits of integration are x values. To find the area with respect to y, the integrand function is f of y minus g of y, or the right function minus the left function, as functions of y, and the limits of integration are y values. Because we are given functions of x, let's first analyze the area from top to bottom, or vertically. Notice the bounded area over the entire interval for x is bounded above by the line and below by the parabola, which indicates it will be easier to integrate with respect to x to determine the bounded area. The limits of integration will be the x values of the points of intersection. But let's also analyze the area from left to right or horizontally. Notice from left to right or horizontally, the area is always bounded on the right by the parabola and on the left by the line. This indicates we could also determine the bounded area with respect to y. However, in this case, we would have to solve both equations for x to write the equations as functions of y, and then to determine the limits of integration, determine the y values of the points of intersection. Because we'd have to find functions of y to integrate with respect to y, let's integrate with respect to x. And if we sketch a representative rectangle of the bounded area, let's just say here, notice the thickness of the rectangle is delta x, which is why we integrate with respect to x, and the height of the rectangle is going to be the function value of the top function minus the function value of the bottom function, which is why the integrand function is f of x minus g of x. So we need to find the x-coordinates for the points of intersection, which are here, which you can see is x equals 0, and here, where the x value is not clear. To find this x value, we'll have to solve the two equations as a system and solve for x. So if we have y equals 5x, and we have y equals 7x squared, let's solve the system for x by performing substitution. Let's substitute 5x for y in the second equation, which gives us 5x equals 7x squared. Set the left side equal to 0. And let's solve by factoring. The right side equals 0 when x equals 0, or when 7x minus 5 equals 0, meaning x equals 5/7. So now we know the limits of integration with respect to x are from 0 to 5/7, which indicates the area bounded by the two functions is equal to the integral from 0 to 5/7 of the top function as a function of x, which is f of x equals 5x, minus the bottom function as a function of x, or g of x, which is 7x squared. Next, we integrate with respect to x. The antiderivative is 5 times x squared divided by 2, or 5 halves x squared, minus 7 times x cubed divided by 3, or minus 7 thirds x cubed. Next, we determine big F of 5/7 minus big F of 0. When x equals 5/7, we have 5 halves times the square of 5/7, minus 7 thirds times the cube of 5/7, minus big F of 0. When x is 0, notice both terms are 0. Simplifying one last time, the exact value is 125 divided by 294. And the decimal approximation is approximately 0.4252. And this is area, which indicates the units would be square units. The area bounded by the two functions, this area here, is exactly 125 294 square units. I hope you found this helpful.